a madman. This match between Machine and Artosis, Machine starting at the 12 o'clock position, 6 o'clock position, we have Artosis in yellow. Yeah, LZ Gamer's been mass gaming, and his stream is extremely fun to watch, and I cannot iterate that enough. Moltrout's been absolutely addicted to it, as have I. I've actually been watching Matt for the past week and a half while I've been writing and not doing commentary. So, yeah, I've been writing for the past week and a half rather than doing commentary. If you go to sc2gg.com/forums, just go to sc2gg.com, click on the forums tab. You can see a lot of the articles I put out. Did a single-player review thus far. I've also got kind of a brain dump of some of the 08 BlizzCon StarCraft II games, also the 2v2, I'm working my way towards BlizzCon 09. I've done a lot of writing, actually, quite a bit of writing in between doing a lot of other stuff. But again, special shout-out to LZ Gamer. He's just awesome. I'll just put that out there. Special shout-out to Machine as well, because he's a trooper. But yeah, livestream.com/LZGamer. Inca also has a stream going up, and he's actually going to go to the World Cyber Games, so... little announcement, pseudo announcement right there. But his live stream link is livestream.com/IncaSC. That's INKASC. Anyway, I guess I'll do all the announcements right at the front. Looks like Artosis is going for a front door seal here on Destination. It looks like we're going to see some sort of Overlord first build. I assume a 12th hatch for Machine. He likes the more economic start opening builds. Anyhow, yeah, CSL. If you guys are in college and you love StarCraft, go to the TeamLiquid.net forums, check out the Brood War section, go look for the CSL thread. And what you want to do is, if you see your college, sign up, talk to your whoever the captain is, help out however you can. Even if you're not playing, I think it kind of would be fun to organize watching and support in general. Looks like there is the hatchery from Machine. He's also sending a drone scout down the line. Looks like he should be able to sneak it in. If you do not see your college on the list, start one. Start a club. Organize with people. I'm going to be actually doing some stuff with the UCSD club in particular, so look for that, you UCSD people. And actually what I really want to do is try to get some pro gamer booths at the Winter Games Fest and invite Berkeley down. Anyway, back to the game. Machine actually able to sneak that drone scout in before that blockade. Looks like Artosis is going to skip sealing that front door and just send that SCV to scout and going to be able to run up, do the harassment. He's going to see exactly what he wanted to see, that early gas from Artosis, which suggests we're going to see some mech opening here. Although, it's not inevitable, generally, yes. And that drone actually going to be able to get an SCV kill on that SCV that completed the barracks. And that drone has to feel good. That's a rare sight, seeing a drone killing an SCV. 40 health on the drone, 60 health on the SCV. Drones, not exactly your beefiest unit. Artosis now coming around to see that 12th hatchery. Looks like that spawning pool on the way. A couple drones transferring otherwise. And it looks like that drone actually coming back to get a little bit more action. Going to hit that supply depot a little bit. Be even more annoying. it's going to see, first of all, no Marines producing. And I'm not sure, I think that's a little bit out of range to see that factory. But, and interestingly enough, a third hatchery right away for Machine, which is a bit dangerous, actually, especially with Artosis opening up with a factory, because Vultures very hard, usually early Vultures, not as much of a problem on Destination, because you've got those narrow ramps, but if a Vulture can sneak through and not get hit, basically, on that, kind of on this double ramp, you can sneak it all the way around, kind of like Zerglings against Protoss Fast Expansion. They're really annoying to deal with. So we'll see if Machine can get a Sutton Colony in position to deal with that early Vulture, or get the Hydralisks out in time to deal with the early Vultures. Looks like he's now placing the gas and start working on a little bit of that tech. A couple Zerglings out in the field. Just one Zergling chasing the SCV scout, the other Zergling running to the front door, and also kind of scoping out that 9 o'clock, it looks like, wants to make sure mines aren't planted there. Artosis, interestingly enough, putting down a machine shop first, so maybe going for siege tanks first to play a little bit more of a safe, fast expansion game, which is a little bit odd, and also going for a command center. Really, I feel like this is a good, solid map for Artosis' style of play. And actually, no, it looks like we're seeing Vulture first, and still no Marines out in the field, and this Zergling going to get some free damage on the supply depot. It'd at least be a little bit annoying and distract Artosis, perhaps. There's that first Marine being produced to try to cope with that first Zergling. At least going to make sure that at least a Marine is produced, and you can't just do straight factory. But he's also going to see this Vulture now backing off. Very nice reaction time on the Machine's part there to pull that Zergling, and the SCV actually taking no damage, still kind of floating around the field. And this is an interesting blockade, actually. Hydralis Den down as well. It looks like Artosis is going to see that planted. But still, yeah, with that Sutton Colony alongside. And that Sutton Colony should be enough to deal with that Vulture should it land all its hits. But not if speed is upgraded, because the speed will actually carry it past that Sutton Colony, a second factory being produced. So these two Vultures actually should be able to sneak around and do a little bit of economic damage. So let's see what Artosis can do with that. But anyway, as I was saying, Artosis, this is the exact style of map he is really good. good at, because he plays a very safe, a very kind of, a lot of people say camper Terran, but a very safe, a very kind of elongated game style. And to put it in plain terms, I guess, he really likes the longer macro games, just camping back and letting his opponent just bang his head on his defense and, ooh, killing the panda bear guy right off. Bad karma. Look out, Artosis. So, although he's in pretty good position here with these vultures, it looks like the speed just upgrading, going to sneak through only a single vulture along the way, only taking two hits, and he is going to be able to get a couple of drone kills here to halt Machine's economy, which is what he needs to do early, actually. But Machine actually able to pin one of the vultures in very nicely, taking one out, minimizing the damage somewhat, but this vulture still already adds a couple kills here, I think, before getting taken out. So getting a few drone kills there, but otherwise minimized fairly well by Machine, and a couple of Hydralisks now pushing out the field. So the only defense, two Marines in the front door. I'm not seeing any tanks produced yet, and going straight to Goliath with range. Goliath with range from Artosis, so maybe thinking about a tech switch to Mutalisks, or maybe thinking that he's just going to play, he's thinking about playing that camper style, which is really strong on Destination in particular, particularly with mech, because once you get siege tanks up on the ridge, it's difficult. Ooh, losing a lot of mining time here, though, with these five SCVs. That's actually a pretty big economic hit here early in the game, but if you just produce a lot of Goliaths early, that's also kind of a hard army to kind of press through with any of the early mid-game tech units. So, and then you can just transition to siege tanks, I guess, after that, go for some early weapons upgrade, and then have that big ball moving out. Also, maybe worrying a little bit, playing against Machine the Man along the lines, a little bit worried about that Mutalisk harass that Machine's so good at. Machine now taking expansion. The problem with this, though, is if Machine just decides to not engage, he's not going to expend any units. Artosis is really, the Goliaths aren't really good for pressing against a Zerg at these defensive positions. He's got the Sultan colonies up. Additionally, I almost feel like that speed upgrade was a little bit of a waste, because vultures into the they're really more effective once you have this outbound expansion here at the 3 o'clock, or the expansion past this really is really when vultures can come to play. So that speed, although the Mensch run to get a couple kills, I'm not sure if it was worth the 100 minerals, 100 gas, and the 75-75 across the board, especially when you're trying to basically do an economic race. And honestly, I feel like Artosis is one of those guys. He's a really smart, very intelligent player, but he doesn't stack up well against Machine in particular, because again, he likes more of that shell style, and Machine loves this sort of game. This is what he really excels at. This is the thing that he really made a name for himself for when he was initially coming through the scene, is just having massive amounts of macro. He can just macro extremely quickly through the mid game, and when he supplemented that with Mutalisk, he just became an extremely dangerous player. So, and I mean, Machine macro, that's really what he loves playing. If you ask him, what is your favorite style of game, he will always say, I want to play the guy head to head all the way to the late game and just play a straight macro fest. And when he has the hatchery's end game, he tends to be very effective with them, utilizes units very well. So let's see how this works out. It looks like a couple turrets down